11 tickets have already been punched, and tonight from Brooklyn, another automatic bid is up for grabs. Robert Morris, the two-time defending Northeast Conference champions, looks to make history and win an unprecedented third consecutive title. But they'll have to knock off one of the hottest teams in the country, LIU, winners of 12 straight and 26 overall, their most in 74 years. Tonight, a champion will be crowned and earn a trip to the big dance. Welcome to Championship Week, presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. Tonight here in Brooklyn, New York, it's the championship game of the Northeast Conference. Robert Morris taking on Long Island University from the Wellness Recreation and Athletic Center. Well, a pair of great semifinals on Sunday for Robert Morris. It came down to the final seconds, and Belton Jones would deliver. The guard out of Philadelphia, 4.3 left, hit that floater to beat Quinnipiac and punch Robert Morris's ticket for the championship game. There are the brackets. LIU during the regular season went 16-2 in conference. They're the regular season champs. Hi, everybody. Thanks for joining us. John Chombi alongside LaFonso Ellis. So here's our matchup, and we start with contrasting styles. As you talk about a Robert Morris team, very good defensively. LIU, they like to get after it on the offensive end.
LIU loves to get out in transition to get easy baskets. They have bunnies who can get out with great speed. For Robert Morris, it's going to have to be a tempo game for them. Terrific. Number one defensively in the NEC. If they want to win this game on LIU's home floor, they have to slow it down and watch for them to front the post.
How about the Diet Mountain Dew head-to-head? We go with a guard and a forward. Belt Jones been playing so well.
He's a pure point creator, distributor, fearless in the main lane, has a terrific little floater as he gets into the crease. For Julian Boyd of LIU, he has big hands, strong rebounder, athletic, so quick. He's their best low-post player.
Starting lineups now. First for Andrew Toole and the Robert Morris Colonials. It'll be Belton Jones, Caron Williams, Gary Wallace, and then up front Lawrence Bridges and Elijah Thompson. They are without their top scorer, Caron Abraham, who is out with an injured Achilles. Meanwhile, for the LIU Blackbirds, it'll be Kyle Johnson, C.J. Garner, and David Hicks, the three-guard attack. Jamal Olasaware and Julian Boyd up front. As we get ready to go, Robert Morris trying to make it an unprecedented three consecutive NEC titles. LIU trying to get back to the big dance for the first time since 1997. So they are packed in here at the Wellness Recreation and Athletic Center. Ready to go. And Boyd wins the tip. LIU controls. And immediately the jumper from Johnson wouldn't go. Rebound tracked down by Hicks.
That's the key to this game for Robert Morris. They cannot give up second chance opportunities to a very good offensive rebounding Long Island team. Second in the NDC in offensive rebounds at 14 per game.
Well, Olasaware not able to hit from in close, and here's Belton Jones.
A key for Long Island is to contain Belton Jones' dribble penetration. He is excellent at getting in the gaps.
That's a two, and it's knocked down by the senior Gary Wallace. All-time leader in games played for the Colonials.
He's really been a tremendous senior leader for this basketball club. Robert Morris will play a lot of man-to-man. They'll front you in the post, and they're excellent on closeouts.
Now we mentioned Andrew Toole, who took over from Mike Rice and moved on to Rutgers. He is the youngest head coach at 30 years of age in Division I, trying to make it three straight NEC championships, seven titles overall, the most in the conference history. And they ride not just an eight-game NEC tournament win streak, but overall they have won eight in a row coming into this one.
They've really improved on all the little things, closeouts, help the helper, all those finer details defensively. They've excelled at.
Elijah Thompson rebounds the Wallace miss, and now Belton Jones. A little stutter step. There's that floater, and it goes.
Such a threat off the bounce, has tremendous burst, which allows him to get in the lane.
Johnson on the baseline. Olasaware drills a three. LIU averages about 83 points a game. And meanwhile, Robert Morris would like this one to be played probably in about the mid-60s. And a travel there. It's a turnover. LIU head coach is a New York native, Jim Ferry in his ninth year, the regular season champs. They have won 12 in a row, and they won the conference two different times, but it has been a while. 1997, the last time they won, and Ferry taking home the hardware as coach of the year in the Northeast Conference. Corner three would go from Hicks, and Robert Morris the other way.
Watch for LIU to double team on ball screen action Belton Jones to try to contain his dribble penetration.
Garner now, CJ Garner into the paint, shot blocked out of bounds.
Elijah Thompson, number 11 for Robert Morris, gifted athlete, banger, shot blocker, really quick reaction getting to the basketball.
Where it gives out.
What a screen.
And they'll say an offensive foul. They get it on Olasaware. Another look.
We talk about technique of ball screens. The guard has to be, in this case, Kyle Johnson, has to wait until Olasaware can get there and set the screen. He begins his dribble. Before he can get there and get set, Olasaware is moving screen. Good call by the official.
So the Colonials with a one-point advantage here early on. And that floater blocked out of bounds. It'll be goaltending. Kenny Onyechi with the goaltending.
They're so good with that dribble handoff action. Long Island's going to have to be better with not losing contact with the ball handler. He's able to get in the lane, Karan Williams, to get that little floater out. Good call by the official. Clearly a goaltend.
Boy, hanging. That didn't touch anything. Popo comes down with it into the lane, shoves off to Boyd. And that one in and out. Rebound on Onyechi. And let's see what they have. Do they have a foul or a tie-up? They got a foul underneath. And it'll be charged to Russell Johnson, his first.
Except one of the keys to this basketball game for Robert Morris is they're playing against an LIU team that's second in the conference in offensive rebounds. LIU's done a terrific job on the offensive board so far.
LIU off to a tough start from the floor, just one out of eight. Inbounded here is the freshman, Jason Brickman.
How would you like to have your freshman coming off the bench and be your assist leader on your team? He gives this team a tremendous lift, plays with terrific poise, never rattled, even against pressure.
Three there from Hicks, wouldn't go. Rebound, Hicks. LIU now 1 for 10 from the floor.
This tempo right now favors Robert Morris. Robert Morris, if they're going to win this game has to be 70 points or less. Long Island wants to get the basketball out and push. Robert Morris forcing them to play a half-court game.
And Charles can't hit. And the loose ball tracked down by Popo. Now the freshman, Brinkman. And Boyd throws it down.
Now that is vintage Long Island basketball, pushing it up in transition to Gibbs. Their bigs run the floor so well. Guards with terrific vision to find them.
Johnson drills a three, Russell Johnson.
He gave his team a tremendous lift off the bench against Quinnipiac. 14 points, 5 rebounds in that game.
Boyd will try it. Onyechi, rebound. Couldn't get the putback to go. Boyd pulls down the miss from Myers. Onyechi, good position and one. Kenny Onyechi, part of that Texas connection, a team located in Brooklyn, and they have three players from the state of Texas.
LIU is terrific when they get in transition. Their guards have excellent vision. Their bigs do a great job of running the floor forward with the finish. But where they're terrific is on the offensive board, taking a little contact and score.
Thanks, Jimmy, for the number one. It's number two, Benton Jones. Number 11, Elijah Thompson. And number 24, Lawrence Bridges. Checking back in for LIU, number one, Jamal Alazaber. And online for LIU, Kenny Onyechi.
All right, Carl, thanks very much. Two-point game here. Villanova, tough loss last night. A shocker. Credit to South Florida. And you see the bracket set up, quarterfinals. It'll be Pitt, UConn, Syracuse, St. John's, and Louisville awaiting the winner of the late one. West Virginia, Marquette, and South Florida, and Cincinnati going on right now. But I wonder if Villanova might be in trouble. We shall see. Our game here, though, LIU off to a tough start. Bonds 3 out of 14 from the floor. I guess Jim Ferry could say, yeah, we're only down two.
Robert Morris is an excellent half-court defensive team, which is why LIU has to get the basketball out in transition where they excel.
Colpo, elbow jumper, that's short. Good look on Yeshi, the throwdown from guess who?
That is 8 offensive rebounds right now for Long Island. Only yielded 2 points, but that could be a big problem for this Robert Morris team.
Nice feed inside of Elijah Thompson.
Elijah Thompson leads the NEC in field goal percentage at 55%. Terrific shot selection by Elijah Johnson.
Olasuwer looking for help. Brickman, bounce pass Olasuwer, and he's fouled. And already you really get an idea of how special Jason Brickman is. The freshman has come in and made very good decisions.
Their offense flows so much better when he's in the basketball game. His teammates love to play with him because he has excellent vision. You saw him just get in a little crease between two guys, has the awareness to kick that thing underneath to give it to Olasuwer.
The last foul was on Elijah Thompson, his first.
Look at his ability to just see the floor on an instant when he has the basketball. I tell you, as a big, you love having those kind of guys on the floor. If you can just move without the basketball, he'll find you in the open areas.
Brickman is a point guard. kind of runs counter to what you'd think as a reputation for being very quiet. In fact, he came on his recruiting visit and his mom told Coach Ferry, Coach, I know he's not saying very much, but trust me, he's really enjoying it here at LIU.
He lets his game speak for him. I like those kind of players. I tell you, he has a good awareness defensively as well. Really good at keeping his players in front of him. Nice find underneath by Gary Wallace.
Wallace finding Thompson. And the Colonials by three. Brickman can't hit that one. Out of bounds. And Robert Morris ball.
The ability to see when you're coming off the curl cuts, the most dangerous guy is the post player who set the screen, and that's a terrific look back underneath to the screen and recognize that the big had to show and help. Good read by Robert Morris.
Wallace pulls up, and the senior hits. Gary Wallace having a good game. He is the lone senior on this Robert Morris team.
A stabilizing force on this team offensively and defensively.
Steal there. Myers the other way. Myers at the rim. Tip wouldn't go. And then it's knocked away from Lajah Thompson, and then they get the foul. Like, they get Michael Culpo.
Number 23, Michael Culpo. His first team's second.
One of the concerns for LIU coming into this basketball game is to limit their turnovers. Though Robert Morris only averages about 69 points per game, their bunnies can really get out in transition because they're explosive, have great speed, especially in open floor.
Bridges at the line, junior from Detroit. They are packed in here at the Wellness Recreation and Athletic Center here in Brooklyn.
Lawrence Bridges is their blue-collar energy guy who held scoreless against Quinnipiac, but that's okay because he rebounds the basketball for this team. Loose balls on the floor, he's going after it.
This is his 11th straight start. They're 9-1 since they put him into the lineup. And right now, Robert Morris, a six-point advantage. Boyd on the baseline, Olasuer, offensive rebound, and he'll go to the line. This is something to keep an eye on this entire game. No team gets to the line more frequently in the entire nation than LIU. A little over 30 attempts a game.
They've made more free throws than their opponents have attempted, and they do it by throwing it down in the post, and their excellent dribble penetration drawing fouls.
That last foul on Gary Wallace, his second.
That's why it's so important for Robert Morris to not get broken down defensively, because when they come and help, the bigs for LIU like Jamal Olasuer do a terrific job on the weak side of wedging those little guards inside, which is how he came up with that offensive rebound.
Now they get to the line a ton. They're not a great percentage free throw team, so they do it in terms of the quantity of the opportunities, not the percentage of makes.
And it's 62% in conference play from the free throw line.
Well, Jones here. Jones gets a piece of the paint, pulls up short with that shot. Olasuer up to Garner. Garner speeding by everybody and goes with a left hand. Nicely done. Jones, offensive foul. Bill McCarthy right there to make the call. Milton Jones' first foul.
Long Island is explosive in transition. C.J. Garner, the ability to put it on the floor. Little bunny underneath.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's. And in part by OnTheLine.com, because your health is on the line.
Now you got Kansas, Oklahoma State coming up, and then Kansas State, Colorado, quarterfinal action set for tomorrow. Texas A&M awaiting the Missouri Texas Tech winner, but Baylor trying to get a win and then face Texas, an opportunity to maybe put themselves in, as Carl Ravitch alluded to. But no Perry Jones right now, suspended indefinitely due to pre-enrollment benefits. He's not playing. Olasuwari close, couldn't get it to go. That is a huge loss. One of the best freshmen in the country.
Well, he gives them shot blocking, rebounding, the ability to score. That's a lot of points, rebounding, and altered shots that they'll be missing.
Definitely a chance that he could leave for the NBA. There's a turnover. Russell Jackson walks with it. Four turnovers on Robert Morris.
So far, the story of this game for Long Island, they don't necessarily burn it up from the perimeter, but they're 1 of 7 from the three-point line so far in this game.
Olasuwari couldn't hit, and I think they got Hicks over the back. They did. We mentioned in the open contrasting styles, and Robert Morris leading the conference not just in points allowed per game, but field goal percentage of defense. And look at the Blackbirds offensively.
LIU so explosive in transition, but Robert Morris, they do a really good job of on-ball defense. Their defensive rotations are really good.
Now right now, Bill McCarthy and Guy Pagano going over to the scorers table. Over the back right now, sure why they'd be marching down. Yeah, everybody was down there, almost looked like they were free throw position. So the foul indeed was on David Hicks, his first, and team foul number 3. 5 team fouls on Robert Morris. 10:41 to go here in this one. John Chabi, LaFonso Ellis. It's the Northeast Conference championship game. Robert Morris trying to make it 3 straight. Yank Charles, lefty jumper wouldn't go. Rebound yanked down Russell Johnson. Karan Williams off balance, Olasuwari rebound.
This is where LIU is so good.
Garner, great move of the layup. A 6-0 LIU run.
That's the tempo that Long Island has to play at. Take advantage of their speed and quickness in the open floor. Nice cut.
Good work there as Karan Williams ran the baseline and laid it in. Robert Morris back out front.
His defender got way up on the high side. Excellent read. Whenever that happens, you should cut it back door. Terrific read by Karan Williams.
Olasuwari into the paint and gets it to go. 8 points for Jamal Olasuwari, the sophomore from Maryland.
His athleticism and length at 6'7 could continue to be a problem, a matchup problem for Robert Morris.
Williams on the baseline. Knocked out of bounds, and it'll be Robert Morris basketball.
Jamal Olasuwari, so good. Tough to defend. Lefty, his ability to hang in the air, draw contact at 6'7", 215. His strength allows him to be able to take contact and still finish over the top.
He has been very good in the NAC tournament. Double doubles in each of the first 2 games, and there's a 3 knocked down by Russell Johnson, and it looked like he may have been fouled.
He's a solid 3-point shooter, but only shooting 28% from 3 in conference.
Olasuwari drills the 3, 11 points, and he is fired up.
He's starting to really feel it, John. He's only 5 of 27 from the 3-point line. But when you can see those tough shots like that going in, it gives you confidence to shoot it from the perimeter.
And right there, they get Elijah Thompson fouling Olasuwari.
aware. He's a driver, athletic defender, doesn't shoot a lot of threes, but he's playing with a lot of confidence. And when you're playing with confidence, it's amazing how those shots that you don't ordinarily make shoot or take, how they drop. Olesa Ware having a really good game so far.
That last foul, Elijah Thompson, his second, team foul number six. Olesa Ware, talking with C.J. Garner there, they actually played high school basketball together. Garner started his college career at South Alabama before transferring here, and gets hooked back up with his high school buddy on the Etchy. Kicks out, now it's Brickman.
They won a state championship together at Springbrook High School.
Nice work underneath. Pucks couldn't get it to go. Yan Charles on the baseline. One and done. Kupo gives off to Brickman. Onyechi had it knocked away and then gets charged with the foul. Tied at 21 here in Brooklyn.
Jamal Olesa Ware has done everything in this game. He's rebounded, he's scored, he's even found the touch with the deep three.
Back here in Brooklyn, a 21 all time, our Northeast Conference Championship game. A packed house, John Chubby, LaFonso Ellis, Robert Morris, the defending champs. In fact, they've won the last two NEC titles. Last year, got into the tournament, lost a heartbreaker to Villanova in overtime, 73-70, and even still, it propelled Mike Rice to the Rutgers job.
Coaches with a lot of energy and a lot of passion from that sideline.
Okay. That's like one way to put it. Belton Jones rattles that home. That's a three.
Always have to be aware of where he is on the floor. They'll ball screen him. He'll give up the basketball, move away, but he's always looking to come back to the basketball. Long Island's going to have to do a better job of being aware of where he is on the floor.
Garner gives to Kupo. Right now, both Garner and Brickman in the game. pair of point guards.
I'd like to see that ball go inside to Onyeka and let him go to work or draw a double team and kick.
Onyeka lost it. Possession arrow goes to Robert Morris.
Felton Jones again will come off the basketball and go hide in the corner, and he'll receive a down screen, of which he'll curl up to the three-point line or into the lane, which is exactly what he did on that play. You cannot lose contact with the guy. He's back in that corner again, even right now. You cannot lose contact with where he is on the floor as a defender.
Olasaware popping out. Jones from deep. And they get a foul underneath. It'll be Lawrence Bridges. That's his first. Team foul number seven. So it'll be one and one.
Then I think Melvin Jones has to have a little bit more discretion when he has the basketball offensively. When he's coming off that little pick and roll action with the way Long Island is double teaming him essentially on the hard hedge out front. The throwback guy is wide open on the baseline. Instead, he comes off and shoots a challenge three-point shot that wasn't even near the basket.
And again, LIU gets the line a ton, but not great at knocking him down. Johnson knocked away. Olasaware into the paint. And one. He has been tough to stop so far in this one. 13 points leading all scorers.
It has been the Jamal Olasaware show. We saw him doing his thing offensively, but showing the quick hands to propel his team out in transition. We talked about over and over again how explosive this LIU team can be when they get in transition.
Double doubles in both NEC tournament games. Got 14 now. And he's also got 5 rebounds, but he went 18 and 12 and 16 and 12 in their quarterfinal and semifinal wins.
What's amazing is he's averaging 13.7 rebounds in conference play in only 22 minutes.
And a turnover, it'll be LIU basketball. 7th turnover on Robert Morris. One of the things you look at with LIU, they love to push the pace. Andrew Toole knew that and knew that they were going to have to really bear down defensively. But Fonz, they don't have a player averaging 14 points a game for as high a scoring a team as they are. Good look. Boyd finds Garner. First lead of the night for LIU.
As a deep bench rotates guys in and out to keep his players fresh so that they can play at that level. But they've demonstrated that they can play at a moderate tempo and be effective up to 26-24 with 5:25 to go. LIU does a terrific job of knowing where their teammates are on the floor and making the extra pass. That was a really good read underneath by Julian Boyd. Saw that he was double teamed, and good awareness on the weak side by Garner to see the double team and the sneak backside, which is how he's able to get such a wide open layup.
Johnson to test the three. Oh, nice. Underneath. Yann Charles catches the air ball and lays it in.
He's the 5th player in Robert Morris history to start as a freshman. Gives them toughness down in the post defensively, but showing his ability to go to the offensive boards as well.
Shot blocked there, and they get the foul there on Julian Boyd. Boyd with his first. Boyd has been quiet early on.
They have to throw that basketball inside to Julian Boyd to allow him to draw double team, which Robert Morris will do right away. And when they play out of those double teams, we've seen them get layups and wide open jump shots on the weak side.
Johnson, another three. Gets it. third three of the game for Russell Johnson.
We talked about on that screen and roll, the throwback guy is wide open. I felt he should have made the extra pass, but made a challenge three. He's on a roll from the three-point line.
And just a 31% three-point shooter. Garner pulls up. That won't go. Rebound, Elijah Thompson.
Again, I think this pace really favors Robert Morris.
And the foul on Garner as he collapsed on top of Elton Jones. Garner charged with his first.
When you're in the pick and roll action with Belton Jones, the throwback has been there for him all night long. Russell Johnson finding his groove from the three-point line and buries it.
All right, Carl, thanks very much. And just across the river from the Big East tournament here in Brooklyn, Robert Morris leading by three and doing without their top scorer and NEC Rookie of the Year a season ago, Caron Abraham. 4 games ago, tore his Achilles tendon against Monmouth. They are 4-0 without him. But a guy who shoots over 40% from three and adds a lot to their team offensively.
47% from the three-point line in conference play, and his team has done a really good job of playing without him. They do it because sometimes when your star player goes out of the basketball game, it allows for your offense to flow more smoothly, and this team is not dependent on one guy, but they get the basketball to the open player.
And as we mentioned, last year they won this tournament, and it was Abraham who was the tourney MVP. Olasaware, that floater wouldn't go. Rebound, Caron Williams. Jones, good look inside. Thompson had it knocked out of bounds, actually lost it out of bounds. It'll be LIU basketball.
Jamal Olasaware getting that left hand, that left paw on yet another basketball to come up with the possession for his team.
Elijah Thompson will grab a seat. And Garner wipes it up the court.
A lot of ball screen action from LIU trying to get Garner in the paint.
One and done there for LIU as the rebound was pulled down by Anthony Myers. Robert Morris doing a good job on the glass in this one. They've actually out-rebounded LIU. High arcing shot, Caron Williams.
20 to 16 on the boards.
And a 7-0 run is ended right there by Olasaware, who's got 16. Charles feeding inside, knocked away. Onyechi gives off to Kyle Johnson, and now Garner. Olasaware fouled on the floor. And that one will be charged to Lawrence Bridges. Foul number 9, so it'll be 1-1, and that is Bridges' second.
Well, Olasaware has an advantage. He's got that left hand. He's really quick at getting into the gaps, but he's 2 inches taller than Lawrence Bridges, and so that's a really tough mismatch because they can throw Olasaware down in the box where he can use his length over the top, but he also can isolate you out on the floor that they've done the last 3 possessions. He's so quick on that left hand. I'd like to see Lawrence Bridges sit on his left hand and force him to go right. When he's done that, Olasaware has had a difficult time scoring.
Olasaware can't hit the front end of the 1-1. And the free throw woes continue for LIU. Jumper short, rebound pulled down by Myers. LIU 4-for-8 from the free throw line so far. Jones hangs and can't hit, knocked out of bounds. LIU ball.
The one-on-one isolation from the top with Bell Jones is something that Robert Morris likes to do, but where they've been successful is when they've gotten him on the side or the top screen and rolls and have thrown it back to the screener, they've had some success with that. I'd like to see them go back to that in the last minute, 45 seconds of this half.
Feed inside, Onyechi gets fouled. Russell Johnson picks up his second, team foul number 10. So it's Onyechi at the line to shoot 2.
Onyechi's really giving them some positive minutes off the bench. 6 minutes, maybe 8 so far in this game. He's giving them 4 points. Where he's so good is on the offensive board, where he has 2, but he's terrific at ducking in as well.
Only a 51% free throw shooter. Brickman checks back in. Kyle Johnson will take a seat. And you look at this, a minute 40 to go. LIU has 28 points. They average 83 a game.
We said at the top that this is a tempo game for Robert Morris. If they want to win it, this basketball game has to be 70 points or less. Where LIU, on the other hand, they want to get it out and run. So far, this pace is favoring Robert Morris. That's why they're up by 2.
Myers way off. Boyd pulls down the board. Looking for help. Onyechi plus 1. Kenny Onyechi absorbed the contact and a chance to convert the 3-point play and give LIU the lead.
Said earlier that I'd like to see LIU throw the basketball inside because they're so big and strong. When Onyechi has it on the inside and Julian Barnes, both of those guys, 230, 240 respectively. hard to guard down in the box.
And again, Onyeka can't convert. I believe they got Boyd with a lane violation. No, they got a foul. His second. So Boyd picks up a foul, his second. Team foul number 7, and a 1-1 spot for Russell Johnson. In a choppy first half. Boyd, first team all NEC. And had himself a great year, but has been held down here in the first half as Boyd has only 2 points.
1 of 6 from the floor. At 17 points, 11 boards, he's been averaging in the last 12 games. Robert Morris has done a really good job against him down in the box, forcing him to catch it off and double teaming right away.
Russell Johnson gets them both. He's got 11.
Russell Johnson gives them a tremendous lift. Robert Morris off the bench can score baskets in bunches. He's shown that here in the first half.
Olasaware. Rickman down. They get it to Olasaware, who hangs, not able to hit. And the rebound pulled down by Yan Charles. And Andrew Toole will call timeout. Robert Morris will have the last shot of the first half. Colonials on top by a deuce. Here in Brooklyn, Championship Week, brought to you by Dick's Sporting Goods, the NEC Conference Championship game. And Robert Morris leading by 2. Winner this one, on to the NCAA tournament. Jamal Olasaware doing whatever he can to take the Blackbirds to the big dance for the first time since 1997. Olasaware with 16 points and 6 rebounds.
The key to this game for RMU has been their ability to rebound the basketball. They're winning the defensive rebounding battle, which keeps Long Island from getting out in transition with missed baskets, forcing them to have to take it out of the basket and take it out of bounds. Perfect way to slow down a high-octane transition team.
Jones using the Charles screen. And then the pass intercepted. Olasaware. And they get a foul. Belton Jones charged with the foul, his second.
Belton Jones, as good as he is with the basketball, felt has been undisciplined on a few occasions, that being one. They've gotten some good stuff out of the ball screening action, throwing it back to the screener, again, making the decision to go in the gap and throwing it away. That's a couple times we've seen that here in this half.
He's now 4 of 8 from the line, and as a team, they're 5 for 12. Jim Ferry's team, the regular season champs, lost 2 games in the regular year, and 1 was to Robert Morris here in Brooklyn. Jones, and that will not go. I think that Andrew Toole, the Robert Morris head coach, would have to say that went pretty much how he hoped. Robert Morris, the defending champs, leading by a point. Jamal Olasaware outstanding with 16 first half points. Robert Morris 33, LIU 32. Now we join Carl Ravitch in the studio with the Cisco halftime report. You're watching ESPN's coverage of the Northeast Conference Championship with the Robert Morris Colonials taking on the Long Island University Blackbirds at the Wellness Recreation and Athletic Center in Brooklyn, New York. Due to time constraints, we move ahead in our coverage. You're watching ESPN's coverage of the Northeast Conference Championship with Robert Morris taking on Long Island University. Tune in to all the ESPN networks between March 1st and 13th for all the excitement of Championship Week. You can catch the action from 190 men's and women's college basketball games as teams battle for conference supremacy. 43 championship games will be featured, including the title games from the ACC, Big 12, Big East, and SEC. ESPN, your home court for Championship Week. Due to time constraints, you move ahead in our coverage after these messages. You're watching ESPN's coverage of the Northeast Conference Championship. It's halftime between Robert Morris and Long Island University. Tune into all the ESPN networks between March 1st and 13th for all the excitement of Championship Week. You can catch the action from 190 men's and women's college basketball games as teams battle for conference supremacy. 43 championship games will be featured, including the title games from the ACC, Big 12, Big East, and SEC. ESPN, your home court for Championship Week. We'll be back with second half action right after these messages. Welcome back to New York. We're just across the river. It's Championship Week, presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. And here in Brooklyn at the break, our Northeast Conference Championship game. And Robert Morris, the defending champs, leading it by a point as they play for that trophy right there. John Chambi, LaFonso Ellis with you. And I think you just go right here. Robert Morris, this game is going to be played, at least it looks, in the 60s. That's right where they want it.
You have to be able to keep it at a good tempo. But when Belton Jones, your leading scorer, is not playing well, you need a boost. And they've gotten a tremendous boost from the bench by Russell Johnson. He's been able to knock down three-point shots. He's been able to rebound for this basketball club as well. And the story for Long Island has been Jamal Olasaware showing his ability, his versatility to be able to get to the basket off the bounce. Not a great three-point shooter, but he's been able to get his feet set, playing with a lot of confidence. Those two guys have really impacted this game for their respective teams.
Our Subway Fresh take, and I think one of the surprises, first half stats, rebounds, plus six for Robert Morris, coming against an LIU team that was third in the nation in rebounding. Olasaware, 17.6 rebounds. His career high is 19 points. So LIU basketball down a point, and we get set to go underway here in the second half.
Look for Robert Morris to do a lot of the same, to continue to play good on-ball defensive pressure, get good rotations, but they got to rebound the basketball. They gave up way too many offensive rebounds in the first half. They got 9 to this really good LIU team on the boards.
Johnson can't hit. Do they get Boyd underneath? They did. Julian Boyd picks up his third. It has been a frustrating game so far for the sophomore from San Antonio, Texas.
Checking in for LIU, number 32, Kenny Onyechi. He replaces Julian Boyd.
So Boyd will sit 24 seconds into the second half. Kenny Onyechi will check back in.
Julian Boyd is their best offensive low block player. But Kenny Onyechi has come into the game and done a really good job for his team. 3 of 4 from the floor for 7 points in that first half.
Steal there by Kyle Johnson. And they get Gary Wallace with the foul. That's number 3 on Wallace.
Gary Wallace, his third team's first on the second half.
Julian Boyd, first team all conference. An amazing story, sat out all of last year with a heart ailment, non-compaction cardiomyopathy. Discovered actually after his freshman year was playing summer basketball, and he cramped up very bad. I mean, really badly. Eventually had to go to the emergency room and underwent tests, and they detected that heart ailment. But his basketball career back on track after being the NAC Rookie of the Year, sitting out last year. Had a great season. Belton Jones. Olasaware rebound. Up ahead to his high school teammate. Garner will lay it in. Boyd continues to look on. He's got that cool towel draped on his head. And LIU leading by a point. Good give off. But they get the offensive foul before Elijah Thompson threw it down. Jim Ferry loves it.
We talk about the ability to get into the lane, but a long start in college basketball comes to a jump stop so you don't get the charge underneath. Anthony Myers' momentum continues to go forward because it doesn't come to a jump stop. Another turnover for this Robert Morris team.
Yeah, that's 12 on Robert Morris. And one of the reasons that LIU, despite shooting 34% the first half of being out rebounded, they've only turned it over 4 times. That's been a big help. And Olasaware with the bucket. LIU with a 3-point advantage. Olasaware matches his career high.
You have to know personnel. Olasaware, he can go right, but loves to go left with that left hand dominance. You have to sit on his left hand, force him to go right.
Garner fouls Belton Jones.
They've been able to isolate Has Long Island. Olasaware out in the top.
And when he does, he loves to get to that left side that he can shoot those little floaters. George, Robert Morse is going to have to make the adjustment, sit on his right hand, left hand rather, and force him to the middle and see if he can score as well off his right side.
Well, Jones at the line. This is an area where he has improved. Last year, Melton Jones at 59% free throw shooter. This year at 71%.
He's had an outstanding tournament. 42 points, 14 assists, and 5 steals coming into this game tonight. Trying to pump his team up as he's coming down the floor, Melton Jones.
1 point game, Olasuwere. Lost the basketball. Ron Williams backs it up. Myers give off. Oh, and the throw down, Elijah Thompson. Garner off the glass and good. Garner's got 10.
LIU has to force the tempo, push the basketball on made and missed baskets. If they can do that, they can win this basketball game on their home floor. They're so much better when they're playing up-tempo basketball.
Jones to the rim, scoop wouldn't go. Rickman really pushing good. It. Garner the layup.
Downsides, John, when your guard to the primary ball handlers take the basketball all the way to the hoop, the offside guard forgets to get back and get good defensive balance. LIU able to take advantage.
Out of bounds, Robert Morris basketball.
Melton Jones goes inside, doesn't get anything, no balance for Robert Morris getting back, and woo, CJ Garner so good at getting to the rim. Julian Boyd has been a non-factor in this game, but he's loving it on the sideline.
Boyd sitting right now with 3 fouls for the tough game. Only 2 points for the first team on conference forward. And no surprise, a 10-0 advantage for LIU in the fast break department. Blackbirds lead by 3. Charles. Copo the rebound. Rickman open 3. Got it. Timeout, Robert Morris.
Ability to push the basketball after made and missed baskets. That's LIU's strength. Stepping into that big 3 is Jason Brickman.
championship game, intensity high both sides. Jamal Olasaware has been tremendous. And here in Brooklyn, the title on the line, but LIU has made the push. The Blackbirds leading this one by six. Andrew Toole calling timeout. See if they can get a good possession. And indeed, Caron Williams gets fouled. He'll go to the line. Michael Popo, like he might have gotten his bell rung. Cringing right now. Media timeout. LIU leads. Carl, two of the quarterfinals set in the Big East, and Cincinnati, their reward for winning that game would be to take on Notre Dame, and then Louisville awaits the West Virginia Marquette winner. LaFonso Ellis, I think you might argue that Notre Dame right now the hottest team in the Big East. Right there, we had a look at Kenny Onyeche, who was sitting over there on the side. This is the play right here. Copo and Onyeche, watch. Oh, bang.
Feel those for a couple weeks.
Wow.
I'm just glad he didn't lose any teeth, because man, your head and mouth bang each other that way. Usually you can find a couple of those little pearly whites on the floor.
Yeah, it looks like Onyeche got it on the chin, Copo on the ear. Brinkman, another three, the freshman.
Allen's done a good job of playing the overplay defensively by Robert Morris, which is leading to those wide open three-point shots.
And right there, it's Myers hanging, couldn't hit, and he'll go to the line. That last foul on Olasaware is second.
Yeah, the inability to guard the basketball one-on-one forces all of your teammates to have to converge to the paint. And if you can get a little kick out, as LIU did there, you find a wide open jump shot.
Long with that free throw. Wow, Robert Morris has won the last two NEC titles. Andrew Toole in his first season as the head coach, youngest coach in Division I at 30 years old.
Turnovers have really hurt Robert Morris. 12 turnovers in this game that LIU's been able to convert to 10 points. That was one of the keys for Robert Morris coming into this game, not to turn the basketball over.
Johnson gives off. Rickman will try another. Look, Kyle Johnson went down hard. He was trying to save it and then just kind of got blocked off. It'll be Robert Morris basketball.
Both teammates really just jumping in front of each other and banging each other out of bounds. Again, so grateful that there's some landing space over there, because sometimes your head and shoulders can catch a chair over on that inline. Nice.
Good move there as Russell Johnson was able to make the move and lay it in. He's done most of his damage from outside.
Off the ball screen action, that throwback is there. Robert Morris has been able to take advantage of it in the first half in particular, and there as well.
Garner to Olasaware.
Olasaware is cramping up. He's grabbing that left calf. Something to watch to see if Olasaware cramps up and if someone will come and substitute for him while they take care of it.
Olasaware, career high 21. And he takes it away. Toss up ahead, Brickman. And they get the foul on Johnson, his third.
The ball screening action for Long Island's been pretty doggone good, too. But where they're so good is when they're dribbling into the painted area, the unselfishness, drawing additional defender, secondary defender, awareness of where your teammate is, a nice little dish underneath to Olasaware.
Two shots for Brickman. Jason Brickman, the freshman from San Antonio, part of the all-rookie team. Olasaware will sit. And Jamal Olasaware is being led to the locker room. Brickman gets them both. Right now, Onyechi, Popo, and Olasaware are in the locker room. And LIU up 9, largest lead of the game for either team.
And with them out, look for Long Island to go to that 2-3 zone that they like to go into, especially when a team is hurting them off the dribble drive.
Belton Jones couldn't get it to go. Fight for the loose ball. Elijah Thompson gets fouled. Bridges tried for that stop, wouldn't go.
We talked about LSU's offensive rebounding prowess, but Robert Morris, being undersized, have done a tremendous job on the offensive boards. That's 10 offensive boards for their team, and they've been able to convert them into 8 points so far in this game.
Thompson, pretty good free throw shooter. Led the NEC in field goal percentage, a 75% shooter from the stripe. Got them both.
Really helped get that win over Quinnipiac. Had 14 points on 5 of 7 shooting from the floor.
Brickman is fouled. Foul on Belton Jones. That's number 3.
John, you have to know as a defender, when you have an offensive player who's moving away from the basket on the dribble drive, you have to just put your hands up and wall up. No reason to force him to foul him when he's taking a floating away from the basket shot. Again, poor judgment there by Belton Jones. He's usually really good, a really good on the ball defender.
Brickman 1 out of 2. as a team. They're 9-for-17 from the line. And again, a group that gets to the line a lot, but is not particularly great at making it. Still in that zone. Caron Williams knocks down the jumper. Williams got the chance to play a lot more. He's always been able to do that, but it's the improved D that's got him on the court.
Elijah Johnson is the perfect guy to have at that free throw line area against the zone because he has the awareness to score first and secondly to make that skip pass as he did on that possession.
Garner's feed knocked out of bounds. Mentioned Olasolaire bothered by some cramping, went to the locker room. He is back by the bench and now at the scorer's table ready to check in. And the foul on Caron Williams, his second.
Caron Lawrence going after the steal, but Garner had the basketball in his right hand. Garner read it well, threw it behind his back to his left and caught him off balance. Usually when you're off balance after a reach that way, you're out of position and you usually foul, as you saw there.
Olasolaire, and it's stripped away. Robert Morris basketball. Colonials led this one by a point at the half. Been a little faster pace to start the second 20 minutes. Well, here in Brooklyn, from the Wellness Recreation and Athletic Center, the Northeast Conference Championship game, the one seed LIU taking on the three seed Robert Morris. Robert Morris, the two-time defending champ. LIU trying to get to the big dance for the first time since 1997. John Chambi, LaFonso Ellis with you. And one of these teams will go dancing. In fact, it'll be the 12th team to punch its ticket to the big dance. And Elijah Thompson with that bucket. He's got 10.
Tell you, Robert Morris is doing a terrific job of attacking that zone, getting it in that free throw line area. Elijah Johnson making good decisions. First time with the pass, that time with the attack to the rim.
Olasolaire turns it over.
Nice extra pass.
Great block there, but they get the foul.
Oh, a defensive transition, not giving anything. No concession there, yet he's doing a terrific job blocking the shot.
That's championship week presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. LIU, the home team, leading by three. Elijah Thompson books the free throw. Elijah Thompson, one of those guys, just plays with a smile on his face. Missed that free throw, but they get the rebound and a chance to tie or retake the lead for Robert Morris.
Elijah Thompson's really good decisions with the basketball at the free throw line area has forced LIU to go back to a man-to-man.
Wallace couldn't hit, but the rebound tracked down by Myers. Colonials have done a great job of rebounding in this one. Wallace, the senior. And over the backboard, out of bounds, LIU ball. Andrew Toole, we get a chance to do Robert Morris' first game of the year against Kent State. One of his concerns, they're very small, would they rebound? He said at that time they would need to gang rebound, and when we talked to him today, he said, you know, we've done a pretty good job on the glass this season.
All five guys going to the defensive boards to take care of it inside.
Rickman finds Onyechi, the freshman, with a great look. Kenny Onyechi with that layup. He's wearing number 30 now. In that collision with Copo, he cut his lip and got blood on his jersey, so switched from 32 to 30. And a foul in the corner.
Kenny Onyechi's given this team a terrific lift on the inside, has a grown man body, and they've been able to get dribble penetration to find him inside, and he's been finishing 4 or 5 from the floor in this game.
See that bandage on his lip as he collided with Michael Culpo underneath. Ugly collision, head to face. That play we talked about.
Been just so glad that no one lost any teeth.
Yep. Now Copo still in the locker room. So you got to figure some type of head injury beyond the laceration it looked like he had in his ear.
Sometimes you get hit just on that right spot there, John. It just really messes up your equilibrium and makes it difficult to really focus.
Well, he reacted that way. Boyd swings to Brickman, who gets into the paint. Finds Onyechi for the throwdown.
Jason Brickman has the basketball in his hands. He's a wizard, has terrific vision on the floor, doing a good job of driving the closeout on the ball reversal. Additional defender comes over. Robert Morris doesn't get a guard, sinking on the weak side to take away that pass. LIU's been terrific at making an extra pass underneath. Onyechi's been a beneficiary on about 3 or 4 of those passes.
Can't convert from the stripe. And the struggles continue for LIU at the line. They are, however, 9 for 13 from the floor this half. And the lead back up to 4.
The difference in the second half, LIU has been, they've been pushing the basketball on misses and makes, and they've been able to get some easy baskets early. Now it's giving them confidence to run the half court offense well.
Johnson's 3 partially blocked. Garner. Garner into the paint. Boyd. And a 2 for Julian Boyd.
I like this lineup that Long Island has in with C.J. Garner and with Jason Brickman, 2 speedy guards there at the top of that zone.
Johnson and Garner fought for the rebound, out of bounds, LIU ball.
C.J. Garner in transition, drawing that secondary defender, and a guy who's been quiet all evening long is Julian Boyd, but steps up and makes the 17-footer when they need it.
Yeah, Boyd frustrated early, and then he picked up his third foul 24 seconds into this, the second half.
Brickman on the floor. You really have two point guards out there making them so much more dangerous in their half-court attack, especially off those ball screens.
Three on the shot clock. Brickman wouldn't go. Rebound, Kyle Johnson lays it in. First two of the game for Kyle Johnson. And the lead back up to 8. 6-0 LIU run. And answered nicely there by Melton Jones. Brickman, Onyechi. Onyechi gets it back, and he's fouled.
LIU has been tenacious on the offensive board. They have approximately 14 offensive rebounds that now, unlike the first half, they've been converting into second chance points. That was a huge key for Robert Morris coming into this basketball game. Long Island's really been taking advantage on the offensive board.
Yeah, size advantage with Onyechi and Boyd and Olasoware. In the second half, it has been a factor. Benny Onyechi, who actually started last year and has been one of their best bench players for Jim Ferry. Ferry, the coach of the year in this conference, as they were the regular season champs and trying to get to the NCAA tournament for the first time since 1997, and a couple of big makes for Onyechi as we close in on 8 minutes to go here in this one. LIU by 7.
Nice.
They find Lijah Thompson. He's fouled, and he'll shoot 2. They get Boyd, and that is his 4th.
I love how Andrew Toole continues to put a playmaker at the free throw line area. Guards are doing a good job of getting inside. Lawrence Bridges that time making a good read to find a cutting Lijah Thompson underneath.
Thompson with a dozen points. Almost the Cinderella last year in the NCAA tournament, lost in the first round in OT to Villanova. A game they very easily could have won.
Talk about Villanova. That's a team that's really struggling right now to find their identity. They may just barely sneak into the NCAA tournament, having lost several games over the last couple weeks.
Good work again. Inside, Kyle Johnson gets it to go.
That was an area that Andrew Toole was so demonstrative about them having to take care of. LIU has been sensational on the offensive board.
Onyechi the block. Olasoware tracks it down, and now Brickman.
Second key to the game for Robert Morris is, could they contain dribble penetration of LIU? They have not been able to do so. Good call by the official.
Foul on Brickman, his 2nd.
LIU has exploited Robert Morris on the offensive board. Onyechi and the crew have been sensational. Another putback, 2nd.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is presented by Dick's Sporting Goods. Every season starts at Dick's.
Also checking in for Robert Morris, number 14, Harry Wallace.
Big 12 brackets, two quarterfinals set, two more set to go. Texas A&M awaiting the winner of Missouri, Texas Tech, and then that Baylor, Oklahoma winner will meet up with Texas. Look at the score by half. LIU scored 32 first half points. They've already got 31. Fonz, how have they gotten the pace to change in the second half?
They've been pushing it on misses and makes that have led to some easy opportunities in the paint. And that's been the difference in this half.
So there's that patented shot by Velton Jones, that kind of no-spin knuckleball release of the floater.
Much better decision-making getting into the painted area by Velton Jones.
Garner off the glass, plus Tex.
One of the keys to this basketball game for Robert Morris was to be able to contain dribble penetration. CJ Garner doing a terrific job of getting an angle to the rim. Just that little step inside changed his angle from going away from the rim to the rim, drawing the contact up and in.
Gary Wallace, the senior, will sit with four fouls. Team foul number 8 on Robert Morris. LIU with 9 team fouls. Garner with the free throw, he's got 15.
Most players on the dribble penetration by CJ Garner would just have kind of a foray to the rim, but that additional bounce and that step inside changed his angle, allowing him to draw that contact.
Jones didn't get the friendly roll. Now a fight for the loose ball. And that one will go for Lawrence Bridges.
Lawrence Bridges always doing the dirty work for this team. Really pretty ball player.
Kyle Johnson off the give from Onyechi, out of bounds. It stays with LIU, 16 left in the shot clock. Checks in and he'll inbound.
See if LIU try to get the basketball in the hands of Olasaware. He's really good for them in the first half. He's cramped up here in the second half, which has limited his opportunities.
Shot clock winding down. Got to put it up. Rickman. And the rebound yanked down by Elijah Thompson.
Good defensive possession by Robert Morris. Good on ball defense.
Elton Jones for a moment had an idea, put it up from about, I don't know, 28.
And Elijah Thompson has been really good when they've gotten it into him to that free throw line area.
Get the foul on Russell Johnson, that's his fourth. Foul number 9, so a 1-and-1 situation for LIU. Blackbirds lead it by 6.
Number 24, Lawrence Bridges.
You saw Lassaware bending over, stretching.
You can tell it's originating into his back, and the way those nerves run down the leg, boy, that can really be tough to deal with. Nice little chiropractic adjustment would serve him well.
I mean, he literally was reaching around and punching himself in the back. And Olasaware has had a brilliant night. 17 first half points. And a career high 22 as he makes one out of two.
Russell Johnson and Elijah Thompson have to get that basketball in that free throw line area. Anytime that they have, they've gotten buckets from it, a three and then a two underneath.
Jones jump stops in the paint, gives off Caron Williams. Brickman the board, here come the Blackbirds.
And because they didn't get it to them in that free throw line area, two contested shots. One a contested three, that one a contested J.
Good look to Boyd. They get the foul to floor. It'll be on Velton Jones. That's his fourth. But LaFonso, 4:23 to go in this one. Boyd's going to the line for two because that was the 10th team foul. Can you afford to take Velton Jones out here?
I'd say a quick rest just to cool and calm him down, because you could tell he was upset about that last possession. But, you know, he's a redshirt sophomore now and a guy that they depend on to get them buckets. And so Coach Andrew Toole has decided to leave him in, but he's got to calm himself down and not allow that foul to take him mentally out of this game.
Allow you 14 for 25 from the line. 8-point game. Close in on 4 minutes to go. Jones, feet underneath. Elijah Thompson is there for two.
I like Velton Jones' poise that time as he got into the painted area. Wasn't enough in the rush. Allowed the secondary defender to come over and make a nice dish to Elijah Thompson underneath.
Elijah Thompson had a good game. He's got 15. Bounds LIU basketball. Andrew Toole's team down by six. Our under four media timeout in Brooklyn. Who's going dancing? We'll find out coming up. BYU leading this one by 6, 3:52 to go. Now look at Times Square. We're just over the river in Brooklyn, but our Big East Championship presented by American Eagle Outfitters. Two quarterfinals set. Cincinnati about to punch his ticket to take on Notre Dame in a late game. West Virginia, Marquette, 9 Eastern. The winner will take on Louisville. Jason Brickman, the freshman, the babyface freshman, doing great work in this game, distributing. He's hit a couple of big threes. And Boyd had an unimpeded path to the bucket. Couldn't quite throw it down, and it skimmed off the rim out of bounds.
Faked that little handoff on the baseline. The deep defender adjusted to the other side. Clear lane to the right. But that was a great job and good reaction by Belton Jones to put his body in position, which changed his angle and forced Julian Boyd to adjust just slightly, forcing him to miss that dunk.
Just a little bit out of his reach. Teron Williams. Rebound tracked down by Kyle Johnson.
John, I've been disappointed that Robert Morris has aborted what's really been damaging for them against that 2-3 zone. The ability to throw it inside to the free throw line area to Elijah Thompson and to Russell Johnson has been so good for them, and they've completely abandoned it.
They got Elijah Thompson bumping Brickman with the body. Four fouls now on Elijah Thompson. Brickman will shoot two. It'll be double bonus the rest of the way for both sides. Brickman, an outstanding free throw shooter. On the season. So Robert Morris now with four players with four fouls. 8-point game, 3:22 to go.
There it is. Russell Johnson was wide open coming to that basketball.
Good look for Belton Jones. Gary Wallace set it up. 6-point game. Timeout, Robert Morris. No timeout on the floor here. Let's check in with Roxy Bernstein at the Big Sky Championship in Greeley, Colorado. Thanks very much. And here in Brooklyn, LIU leading by 6, 3:09 to go. Possession arrow favors Robert Morris. And you see 10 team fouls on Robert Morris, 9 on LIU. So everybody will be shooting 2 the rest of the way. Been a tough game for Julian Boyd as he has come up with only 5 points in this one. Robert Morris trying to make it 3 straight NEC titles. LIU trying to get back to the big dance, first time since 97. Wallace the rebound, and the Colonials look to cut into a 6-point deficit.
Elijah Thompson is wide open in that free throw line area. They got to throw that basketball in.
Wallace a 3. Good rebound, Kyle Johnson.
Well, they're awfully good.
Wow, Boyd, look out! Brinkman on him. Teron Williams from way deep. Elijah Thompson inside. Won't go. Rebound. Russell Johnson in the putback. Robert Morris calls timeout down to 1.
This LIU team can be explosive in transition. I love the lineup when Brickman and C.J. Garner are in the basketball game. Nice lob backside and the flush by Julian Boyd. Been quiet this game, but exclamation point in that transition.
I remember watching LaFonso Ellis throwing it down on a couple of lobs while at Notre Dame like that, huh?
I don't know if I could extend like that. He makes it look a lot prettier than I did, John.
Okay. You're gonna go humble on John Shopping, LaFonso Ellis here courtside in Brooklyn. It's the NEC championship game. What's at stake? Robert Morris trying for an unprecedented third straight title. LIU trying to get back to the dance for the first time since 97. Contrasting halves. First half played at Robert Morris's pace. Second half more to LIU's liking. Oh, there's a steal by Belton Jones. Wallace buries a three. And that defense impacting the game for the Colonials.
Back into that 1-2-2 zone of Robert Morris. Let's see if LIU can attack it without that high ball screen or hitting someone flashing to the basketball.
Olasolare off the glass and good. 24 as he adds to his career high.
Olasolare with a nice little flash from the weak side to strong side, able to find him underneath for that little hook.
Johnson from way deep. Elijah Thompson has been great on the boards, gathers it. Belton Jones off the glass and good. Robert Morris calls its final timeout.
Been really impressed with Belton Jones's poise on the last few possessions when he gets into the painted area. LIU has been outstanding with getting it done in the paint. Their ability to put it on the deck. One of the keys for Robert Morris was, could they contain dribble penetration? They've not been able to do so. LIU's been able to exploit that aspect of the game, and their bigs have been finishing it inside. And then the second key was, could they keep LIU off the offensive boards? They've not been able to contain it at any level. LIU's been dominating the offensive boards.
Jim Ferry going over what he wants his troops to do. I thought it was interesting that Robert Morris burned its final timeout in that spot. You get 55.9 to go, 3-point game. It's a good chance that this may come down to the wire.
He wanted to get his team organized and make sure they got in some good pressure. What he's going to try to do is go for a steal in the backcourt, see if he can get a 10-second count. And then play good defense, try to get a good defensive possession, force a missed shot, and then go back down, because if they can get the defensive rebound, they're only down three, they go for a quick two, get some more pressure, they don't come up with it, then they're going to have to play a foul game. And for a team like LIU, who doesn't shoot the basketball very well, from the free throw line, only 62% in conference, I think that's a good decision to call that timeout and get his team organized. See if they'll go man or 1-2-2. I'd expect them to go man for this possession.
Brickman walking it up. Wallace out on him. Olasolare, 10 on the shot clock. Olasolare turns it over. 3-point game.
Didn't allow Olasolare to get to his left hand in that possession.
That's a three. Got it. We're tied.
If I'm Long Island, I want to take the very last shot to not allow Robert Morris to be able to come down with an extra possession. I'd like a high ball screen here to allow Brickman or Garner to get into the lane.
Got to go here. Garner. Tip. And we're going to overtime. You surprised it didn't call timeout?
I am. I believe that Jim Ferry trusts his two guards that are on the floor in Garner and
Brickman to make good decisions with the basketball. I would have loved to have seen a high ball screen. I think that could have freed them up to be able to shoot the J or get into the lane area. But what a big, big three-point bomb. Lookin couldn't get anything around the horn. And the dribble penetration, little gamble there by Garner. Escape dribble to the left side. That is a huge three-point bomb there by Russell Johnson, who's been terrific all night long. I really felt that they should have gotten a little high ball screen. It could have freed Garner up to get a better look at the basket, but decide to allow him to go one-on-one. But that's tough against a really good Robert Morris team, who really loads it up defensively against the dribble penetration.
So Russell Johnson's 4-3 of the night sends us to OT. Back to the studio, here's Carl Ravitch. Jason Brickman, the freshman, trying to lead LIU to the NAC title. Jamal Olasuwere right there, career high 24. He has been bothered by cramping in the second half. And Belton Jones and Robert Morris trying to make it three straight NAC titles. Back to Olasuwere for a second, though, LaFonso. You just tell by his body language and his legs. He is gutting it out here in the second half. Olasuwere has been stretching and moving and just generally looks uncomfortable out there.
That lower back starts to tighten up to get the way the nerve endings go all the way down into the legs areas. It can force you to cramp up around your knee and in your calf, depending on which nerve it is.
Oh, great work there. Caron Williams takes it away from Brickman and then lays it in. Boyd had won the tip. But Caron Williams with a huge bucket. And Robert Morris up by a bucket.
Three impact players have four fouls for Robert Morris. Thompson, Jones, and Johnson.
Olasuwere just asserting his will, 26.
How about the guts and the courage from this guy to not cash it in? NEC title on the line, cutting it out for this Long Island team.
Inside, Russell Johnson is fouled. He'll shoot two. Double bonus the rest of the way. That foul on Johnson, his first. Foul trouble, though, for Robert Morris. Elijah Thompson with four, Melton Jones with four, Gary Wallace with four, and the man at the line, Russell Johnson, with four.
Three out of those four guys in double-figure scoring. How about the job that Russell Johnson has done off the bench? 19 points off the bench. Giving his team a tremendous lift.
Johnson makes them both, and Robert Morris up by two.
I expect Robert Morris to go into that 1-2-2 zone. If they can do that, it can protect their four players who are in foul trouble with four fouls.
The NEC Conference Championship game, Olasuwere. Trying for the offensive rebound, picks it up. Right hand wouldn't go. And it's out of bounds. It'll be LIU basketball.
I felt when he was able, Olasuwere, to come up with that offensive rebound, he was so far underneath the backboard. I would like to see him throw that basketball out to give them a good possession offensively. They're fortunate to come back up with that basketball.
Led by as many as nine here in the second half. Brickman right to the goal and lays it in. 13 for the freshman. We're tied up. And a reminder coming up next, Championship Week presented by Dick's Sporting Goods continues. Big Sky Conference, Montana and Northern Colorado. Good look inside. They find Thompson. Six on the shot clock. Melton Jones pulls up and hits. Twenty for Melton Jones.
Got off to a slow start in the first half, but he's really impacted this game in the second half and the overtime with some really good, cool, under control decision making with the basketball.
We asked Jim Ferry, what do you need to do tonight? And he said, contain Melton Jones.
They did a really good job, LIU, against him in the first half, loaded him up, loaded up the box against him to take away his angle, forcing him to take some tough shots, but good poise, allowing the defense to kind of develop. Saw a little crease, stepped in that crease, elevated and knocked that shot down. And at the end of games in tough situations, you want the basketball in your best offensive scorer's hands. Melton Jones is that guy for Robert Morris.
Here, the 30th anniversary of the Northeast Conference. One of these two teams will be going to the big dance. And if you go back to the start, it was Robert Morris and LIU meeting for the first ever Northeast Conference championship. And we mentioned 1982, and went to Robert Morris by a point. That one played at the Paramount Theater. And then in 83, Robert Morris did it again, this time by a dozen. And finally in 84, LIU the win. And on to the NCAA tournament. Those games played at the Paramount Theater. It's actually the home of Blackbirds basketball until 2005. It was originally a movie theater that sat over 4,100 people. Here we are at the Wellness Recreation and Athletic Center, and a packed house here. Garner now. Hicks gives it to Brickman, 11 on the shot clock. LIU down two. Olasewer spinning. Hanging, hitting! Score! 28 for the sophomore from Maryland.
Sometimes, John, he had his feet all crossed up on that shot, but when you've been hot the way he is, sometimes you can just throw it towards the basket and it'll go in for you.
Garner steps in. And that one tipped out of bounds. It'll be LIU basketball.
I've been so impressed by C.J. Garner's speed, his anticipation, stepping into the passing lane to get a deflection so quick with his hands to come up with that possession for his team.
LIU a chance to take the lead, under two to go.
This game's going to come down to can Robert Morris defend the ball screening action and contain dribble penetration off of it.
Olasewer in the baseline. Well, I'll tell you what, I keep yapping about that he's cramping. Regardless, he's got 30. And we're under 90 seconds to go. He's given LIU the lead.
It's going to be so important for Robert Morris to recognize flat drives versus threatening drives. That time they came and didn't have to, and that opened up that pass along the baseline.
Foul on Olasewer.
Brickman using that ball screen at the top, but you can see he's contained and you don't have to come and help. That time Melton Jones peeked at the basketball, which allowed Olasewer to go on the baseline to come up with that layup. You have to be really disciplined defensively in the last few minutes of the game.
And Johnson with a free throw miss. That's his first miss from the line tonight. And now it's a one-point game. Yeah. finding Boyd. Olasewere. Jamal Olasewere has been everywhere the last minute and a half. They just got Russell Johnson with the foul, and he has fouled out. And Russell Johnson finishing with 21 and 7. And was a big lift to Andrew Toole's team.
And I could be wrong, but I don't think Russell Johnson was involved in that play. I felt that that's erroneously charged to him. I didn't think he was anywhere in the area. That's Caron Williams underneath. You can see as the ball goes up, that's Caron Williams. That's not. Wow, that's a huge erroneous call there. Russell Johnson nowhere in that play. That foul should be on Caron Williams.
Yeah, they put it on Caron Williams, which is correct.
Not that Caron Williams is expendable either, but Russell Johnson has been outstanding in both halves and the overtime.
To go. From the corner, Wallace. Rebound, Russell Johnson, and he's fouled. They get a Olasewere. And that's his fourth.
Caron Williams' extra effort on the glass to get his hand on that basketball to keep it live for his team. Allowed for Russell Johnson to get a second chance opportunity. Good reaction by Caron Williams on the boards.
Johnson missing the free throw.
And the difference on that last one versus the ones that he's made from the free throw line. He's not finishing all the way through on his shot. Just as he released that basketball, he kind of pulled it back. And when you do that, it can make your shot short, as it did on that one.
And he's grimacing a little bit.
Hand in the cup. It's amazing how many go in when you leave that hand up there. Get those fingertips into the rim.
Hicks handling here. Got a 9-second differential, shot clock to game clock. 1 point LIU lead.
Robert Morris's ability to guard the ball screen that's going to come for Long Island will determine the outcome of this game.
Hicks. Olasewere the rebound. Lost the ball. Boyd tried to save it. And it will stay with LIU. 8 seconds left.
If you're Robert Morris, you have to go for an initial steal. If you don't get it, have to foul right away.
Andrew Toole telling him they got a foul. They get it to Brickman, and then they foul him. Brickman, a great free throw shooter.
Missed an opportunity, John, to foul Julian Boyd. He's only a 59% free throw shooter.
Thompson charged with the foul. He's done with five. Brickman went down hard.
Fall on that hip. Sometimes you get a little pointer and it can shoot through your entire body in that hip area. Glad to see him get up and he's okay. But I tell you, Robert Morris missed out on an opportunity to foul Julian Boyd there on the catch, the initial receiver on the out of bounds play. 59% free throw shooter, but instead they don't foul him and they foul Brickman. Brickman, an 85% free throw shooter in conference. Elijah Thompson has had an exceptional game for Robert Morris. Went out of the basketball game with 15 points.
All right, now, if he makes this, does Jim Ferry foul?
I'm of the old school that feels if he makes this one, I would definitely foul and put them on the line.
Got them both, 3-point game.
And there's no right way to do it. It's just as the percentages suggest that when you foul, you have a greater opportunity to close out the game.
Oh, they almost turned it over. And Robert Morris calls timeout. That was amazing. 6.1 to go. LIU, a 3-point lead.
Ron Williams not quite aware. Everyone trying to get instructions from the sideline. Almost gave an opportunity away, but alert to see the basketball coming and was able to control it.
LIU 6.1 seconds away from their first NCAA tournament appearance since 97. We send it back to the studio and Carl Ravage.
Possibility of making one, missing the second. It's highly improbable. Look for Robert Morris to get the basketball into the hands of Velton Jones and allow him to create. He'll try to shoot it himself or get it to Karan Williams or Russell Johnson.
Can they get it off? Johnson, short. That one out of bounds. And it'll be Robert Morris basketball. 0.6 seconds left.
Karan Williams ran the wrong way on that possession. Almost got in the way of Lawrence Bridges taking that shot.
Officials now are looking at the clock.
Goes up. Balls in one, balls in two, balls in three. Balls out of bounds. I'm going to say about 0.1, John. Sorry, 1 second on the clock. Forgive me.
Bill McCarthy, Guy Pagano over there. All right, so one more look. Yeah, maybe 1.1, 1.2. Well, here at the Wellness Recreation and Athletic Center in Brooklyn, LIU, the Blackbirds, trying to get to the NCAA tournament, trying to become the 12th team to punch its ticket to the big dance. Andrew Toole and Robert Morris trying for the miracle comeback. 0.8 is what they have on the clock now. So Robert Morris trying for the heave.
They have enough time for a catch and shoot. I'd like to see Russell Johnson, Caron Williams, or Velton Jones take that shot.
Why do you even play defense inside the three-point line? Johnson. And LIU, for the first time since 1997, they're going dancing. The Blackbirds are the champions of the NEC. The Long Island Blackbirds are the champs in the Northeast Conference. An overtime battle, and one look at the final play.
Got the hand, got it into the hands of who you wanted to get it, but the late challenge there by David Hicks forced him to fade away a little bit, which caused that shot to be a little short. Good defensive execution by LIU.
LIU wins it here in Brooklyn. A thriller in overtime. And the Blackbirds over Robert Morris, 85-82. So the Northeast Conference Championship goes to Long Island University. Up next, Championship Week continues with the Big Sky Championship. For LaFonso Ellis and our entire crew, I'm John Chabi. Time to send you to the Butler Hancock Sports Pavilion in Greeley, Colorado. And we hand it over to Roxy Bernstein. Congratulations. That was great. You were great. You were great.
One, two, one, two, one, two.
All right, fans, at this time, we ask that you please direct your attention to center court, where Lori Morris.
Coach, what were your thoughts on that last possession?
You know what? Just don't go in. I know these kids played their hearts out. Robert Morris played their hearts out, made big plays, big shots to tie it back up. Our kids showed great poise, great composure, and we grinded it out. I'm so happy for our guys.
Congratulations, Coach.
Thank you very much.
Jamal, what's this game mean to you and your team?
It's just all a blessing, man. It's a storybook ending for us, man. For our two seniors, I just love it. I'm glad we won this one. I'm glad we pulled this one out, man. It's all a blessing.
Thanks a lot. Great game.
Thank you.
Congratulations,
Thank Coach. You.
Thank you. Thank you.